Hey there, it's James Francis here. Welcome back to the channel. Yes, I know it's been a very long time since I've uploaded a video to this specific YouTube channel, but that's because I've been helping our clients, our customers and so on with their businesses and also speaking with our email newsletter as well. So in this video, I want to give you a state of the industry report. Yes, a lot has happened over the last few years with regards to coronavirus and other things and trends as well, but I want to help you with that. Specifically, are online businesses still profitable? And also, as a complete beginner, is it still possible to get to six figures a year from scratch, from zero, without selling your soul to the devil, right? So in this video, I want to help you with that stuff. So if you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And also don't forget to like the video if you enjoy it as well. So let's talk about the elephant in the room, the coronavirus pandemic and how that has impacted online businesses and how that looks today right now. So at the beginning of the coronavirus pandemic, everyone was freaking out, right? Myself included. I think it was February 2020 or March 2020 when everything started to kick off in a big way. And, you know, we all didn't have a clue what was going on, right? And businesses were closing their doors, making these emotional knee-jerk reactions to stop all of their advertising and all these other weird and wonderful things that businesses should never do, right? So that obviously impacted lots of different businesses in many different ways, but it also impacted the consumer or the prospect because they were in this new world, this world of weirdness where they were having to stay home and not go outside. And if they did go outside, they were scared they would get the dreaded coronavirus, and many people still are, right? But it is nowhere near as bad as it was back then in terms of business. So many people nowadays are very optimistic, and this is what we've seen with our own business, working with our clients, new clients coming on board with ourselves, and you know, our coaching clients as well with their businesses, and our agency service clients with their businesses when we're building the businesses for them and so on. We are a very integral part of these people's lives and businesses. So we are seeing behind the scenes of lots of different businesses, probably hundreds of different businesses every single week. So we are seeing a massive uplift in positivity and optimism. Okay, back then it was like the world's gonna be doomed, we're all gonna die, you know, all this negativity and pessimism when the coronavirus thing started out, right? But now what we're seeing is a lot more confidence in the buying process and a lot more people are, you know, purchasing. So conversion rates are going up compared to what they were before. Okay, so our results across the board have increased over the last few months. Specifically, we've made over $60,000 in the last few months, even during a pandemic or whatever else. And I think this is largely due to the fact that a lot of people are getting vaccinated and a lot of the world is opening their doors again, depending on the country you live in, of course. And the large belief and consensus from people nowadays is that things are getting better and it's only a matter of time before this whole thing blows over, right? So people are very optimistic now compared to where they were a year ago. So it's going to be easier for you to start getting some incredible results in your online business. The second thing here is that even though people are more optimistic, that does not mean they are less jaded. In fact, they are more jaded because they are aware of what could happen if things go wrong with their finances again because they've been there before, okay? So even though people are spending money, they're more careful with who they spend it with. In other words, they're more jaded to claims that you make. Okay, and we've seen this across the board with our business, with our clients' businesses. People are just, you know, not believing a word you say unless you have the magic three things. And what are those magic three things? Is it some magical fairy dust? No. It is the good old know, like, and trust factor. Okay, do they know who you are? Do they like you? And do they trust you enough to make that purchase decision? Okay, so in your personal branding, within your business, you should be showing yourself as your true self as always, but now more than ever. This includes using social media and so on, which you may not have done in the past, but I think nowadays it's more necessary to show yourself as yourself and for people to know who you are. And also a big thing behind getting people to like you is just to be yourself. Don't be afraid to smile. You know, it's okay to smile. A lot of entrepreneurs are way too serious, and don't be afraid to crack a few jokes here and there. I crack the worst dad jokes in the world, and that's just me being myself. I am literally like that in real life, but I want to show myself with my own personality on camera, in my blog posts, in my products, even when emailing customers and clients and replying to their questions. I often, you know, just speak with my own voice. You know, don't be afraid to do that because that helps people to like you and also to trust you as well, which is the next thing. You know, obviously trust is earned. Usually you are guilty until proven innocent in this economy, especially nowadays, just recently over the last few weeks and months. But over time, people do learn to trust you because you stick to your promises, you have their best interests at heart, and you're always trying your best to help them. That includes going above and beyond with your products, going above and beyond with your free content on your list, and really delivering as much value to your prospect as possible so they can get to their end goal faster in a much easier way. So if you're following the old approach of just ramming offers down people's throats until they buy and they submit and they tap out like, no, no more offers, please, then you ram them with five more upsells and then they just have a terrible customer experience, it's not gonna work out too well for you. It's all about having their best interests at heart, making sure they know, like, and trust you while trying to actually help them. It's a weird concept, right? You help other people to get what they want, and they will help you to get what you want. Okay, it's a weird concept, but it works amazingly well. Now we move on to the third thing, that when people do know, like, and trust you and they purchase from you, they have more urgency to get to their end goal. Because of everything that's happened, they may have lost their job and they may have only just got employment again, but they know it's not a stable foundation. They're just kind of walking on eggshells. They know that it could be a ticking time bomb. Okay, so for the most part, people have much more urgency to get to their end goal. Now, this is not just related to finance or, you know, I mentioned the example of their day job and so on. It's not just related to that. It's related to everything in the world. Like, people have this weird urgency right now that they want to get to their end goal ASAP. Like, it needs to happen tomorrow, okay? And they will happily pay you a larger sum of money to be able to do that. So what we're finding is that even though during the pandemic, the low ticket offers were, you know, prevalent across the world, and many businesses were just shifting their focus from high ticket offers to low ticket offers, that's slowly creeping back again, where more people are paying you larger sums of money for increased amounts of value. That includes stuff like masterminds, done for you services, coaching programs, that kind of stuff which has a high perceived value because they get some incredible results from them. They want that kind of stuff because they want results tomorrow instead of like, you know what, it's something that's on my radar and I'll do it whenever. I think this whole pandemic thing has shifted everyone's focus to get results ASAP, and it's kind of removed that procrastination from a lot of people, especially, for example, in the weight loss industry. Many people are staying home, they aren't able to get to the gym like they were before and so on. Only just recently have gyms started to reopen, at least in the US anyway. But you know, for the most part, they haven't been able to exercise, so they may have gained the quarantine 15, which is the term coined in the weight loss industry of the average amount of weight people put on during quarantine, so they want to lose that weight to get back to where they were before. For example, you know, all these other things as well, all these other different niches and industries, people have been prevented from getting the results that they want, and now they can. Now things are starting to open up again. They are now in a position to be able to do those things. So they have a massive amount of urgency to get to their end goal as fast as possible. So the fourth thing is traffic. Let's talk about traffic a little bit. How has that been impacted by the coronavirus pandemic, and how are things looking right now to this very day? How is it? Is it better for you? Is it worse for you? Well, let's talk about that. Specifically, Facebook. Oh, Facebook, how I love and loathe you, okay? I have a love-hate relationship with Facebook, but I'm not gonna get into that in this video. The traffic scene nowadays is much more competitive compared to where it was a year ago or 2 years ago before the pandemic. So before the coronavirus pandemic happened, Facebook, in their infinite wisdom, decided to tweak their system to be more trigger-happy with account bans, okay? Now, if you're wondering what I mean by that, it's when you log into your Facebook account and it says your account has been disabled, this is our final decision, you are worthless, and you are nothing more important than what's on the bottom of our shoe, right? They will treat you like a criminal when this happens, even if you've never done anything wrong, and it's their system being overly trigger happy. So just to give you an example here, we had a client create an ad account the other day, only opened the account banned. Like, what? Like, they had a Facebook account forever, no issues whatsoever, but they had their account banned or disabled straight away. They had to upload their ID, and they uploaded their ID, and they came back saying, sorry, we don't have the amount of employees to review this case right now, so your account has been left permanently disabled, which is ridiculous. Now, I can speak about this all day long. I have a rage with Facebook right now, but this is what's happening. Many people are being shut out of their Facebook ad accounts through no fault of their own, us included. We haven't ran a Facebook ad in months because of the fact that they have no employees to look and actually review the policy violations that we did, which we didn't do because we always stick within them. We teach this stuff for a living, for whose sake? Anyway, you know, they don't have the employees doing their job, you know, working at full capacity like they used to because of the pandemic. And I think it's going to take a while before things start getting back into shape again in their company, in the policy department and so on. Yes, they're doing the best they can and so on. I respect them for that. But, you know, they need to do better, honestly. And there's currently a mass exodus away from Facebook to the hundreds of other different traffic sources. I had a client ask me the other day, James, you know, our online business is still profitable now that Facebook is clamping down on different ad accounts for no reason. And I'm like, dude, what did you do before Facebook ads? Of course, right? There are tons, hundreds of different traffic sources out there. Off the top of my head, on the spot, there's Snapchat, there's Twitter, there's Google ads, there's YouTube ads. You know, there's solo ads, influencer marketing, everything else, right? There is so many different opportunities out there to get traffic, right? Not including SEO, not including the free organic methods as well that we teach in our programs and so on, right? So do not think that your entire online business is ruined because one business, one company decided to shut your account down. It's the equivalent of having a house, having a broken window, and then just getting rid of the whole house, knocking the whole thing down because of one broken window. It's not how to run a business, okay? So even though, you know, Facebook is not being great, there is a mass exodus away from Facebook. So I would recommend, if you do have an active Facebook ads account, create a backup account within Facebook and also have a backup traffic method ready to deploy, or even deploying at the same time, running at the same time as your Facebook ads. Because if Facebook decides in their infinite wisdom you've done something wrong, even though you haven't, then it can take weeks or even months or years to get your account back. And in that time, your business is flatlining, all right? So always have a backup traffic method. Now we move on to the final thing, is that due to the coronavirus pandemic, a lot of people lost their jobs, lost their incomes, investments, that kind of stuff, right? So these people were looking for ways, and you may be one of them, to start an online business. Okay, so by doing that, they are purchasing programs like ours, coaching programs like ours and our competitors and so on, to get started online, to start that online business, right? But what does that mean for you? Well, you're not the only one doing that, or these other people aren't the only people doing that. So the more people who are looking to start an online business, the more competitive it's becoming. Okay, so the longer you leave this to get started, the more difficult it's going to be for you. Okay, so many people say to me, James, it was easier back in your day when you got started online. Yes, I got started in 2008. However, it was definitely not easier. Okay, back then there wasn't such a thing as, you know, WordPress or ClickFunnels or anything like that where you can click on the screen and create your website. I had to hand code my entire website with HTML and CSS code. I don't think people nowadays realize how difficult it was back then, because you just automatically think it's easier back then. But honestly, it wasn't. I had to take a part-time college class, which took me 6 months to pass, just to be able to create a very basic website for my business. You can get it done now in less than 1 hour using something like ClickFunnels or WordPress, okay? So it's actually much easier to do the tech stuff nowadays than it was back then, not to mention the fact there are more people around to help you with that tech stuff. But also, when it comes to your competitors, you know, they're the ones helping you to grow your business quicker, because you can see what's working for them, which shortcuts your trial and error. So model what your competitors are doing, that will help you to accelerate your success, all right? So don't think that, you know, it's too far gone now. It's no longer possible to be competitive in this market right now, in this economy and whatever else. That is not true. That's based on emotion and not logic and the data. We have clients join our agency services all the time, and we're able to get them to 10K a month in a matter of months, from scratch, from zero, when they have never entered this market before. You could not do that if it was too competitive. Right? So that's just a limiting belief that you may have. But the longer you leave this, the more difficult it's going to be. All right, so I would highly recommend hitting that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed to get more videos like this, and like this video if you've enjoyed it, hit that thumbs up button, and hopefully by following the advice on our channel and within our programs and services, you will know how to start your online business successfully. All right, so hopefully you've enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day.